group is Melvin Gibbs' elevated entity. The album is called Agent Speaks. It's released March 17th on Live Wire Music in the US. And basically, the record is about connecting the different threads of the African experience in America. So I have people from Brazil on there, I have some people from Cuba on there, I have someone from Lagos, Nigeria on there. I've got a lot of great quote-unquote jazz musicians, guys like John Medeski, and the great guitar player Pete Cosey, who played on all the great Miles records like Agatha, Pandre, etc. I have Blackbyrd McKnight, who was the guitar player with Parliament Funkadelic for many years. Craig Taborn, a good friend of mine, Mark Batson, who's been working with Dr. Dre for the last couple of years. I have James Hurt playing keyboards on there. Got the drummer from Harriet Tubman, J.T. Lewis, playing on it. Got the great Tarion Gully on it. I've got a couple of really great bands from Bahia, Brazil. The Afoxe band features the Korin Efan. Got Cortejo Afro, one of the group upcoming local Afros, playing on there. Essentially, it's about connecting the different experiences in America. The basic starting point for the record was this trip I did to Costa Rica. And when we were there, we drove out of our way to go to this quote-unquote black town. And, you know, after driving for a couple of hours and getting to this black town, we pull up in the town, and there's this woman selling cashews on the side of the road. And I looked at the woman, and she looked exactly like one of my relatives. I mean, she could have been my aunt's, like, twin sister. And I'm looking at her, and she's looking at me. I know she's thinking the same thing. I was like, who is this guy that looks like he's a part of my family? Where did he come from? And at that point, I kind of realized, wow, I could really have relatives
anywhere.
You know, Jamaica, Cuba, you know, because of the way we ended up in America. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to make a record that kind of reflected that idea, and that's the basic idea behind what Ancient Speaks is about. I've got some rap on there. I've got a couple of great Brazilian rappers. I've got a couple of great American rappers. And part of it is also dealing with the idea of Ancient Speaks is that it's really intergenerational. So I'm going from real traditional stuff that could have existed 200 years ago with really current production techniques, because I really want to make that connection like you have.
Yeah. Excellent.
So that's the basic idea of the record.
Did you think that this situation now with the new presidency kind of also had a little spark?
Well, I think it has a spark for the idea of the way guys my age think about life and think about music. I mean, our generation, which, you know, which I kind of call the Obama generation, our generation is really about uniting things.
Yeah.
You know, because we came up through that era when we really thought, okay, we're, you know, the people who right before us had actually gotten civil rights, and we're kind of like, okay, we're going to come and we're going to change things.
We can do this.
Yeah. And then as things went on, it became obvious that the system was going to be resistant to that idea.
Yeah.
And the next set of people behind us had to, you know, do some pretty extreme things to get themselves, you know, selling drugs in the community and all of these kind of things that were detrimental to the community as a whole to put themselves in a position that they were in.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm not saying that in a judgmental way, even though I feel it. I'm just saying it that they, to accomplish the goals that got accomplished, you know, the techniques weren't the best for the community, in my experience, in my opinion.
Mm.
But it's gotten to the point where you have guys who are our age in position of power who still think in terms of, okay, we gotta, everything's gotta work for everybody.
Yeah.
So to the extent that that idea that everything's gotta work for everybody is a part of the culture now, it's very important for guys like me who think in terms of unification.
Of course, yeah.
And that, I think, I would say that, yeah, that idea of being in public consciousness is part of the reason that this record is coming out now. I would say that's true.
Interesting. I mean, it's very, I'm 45 also, so, you know, I think it's one of the only few peaceful things going on at the moment.
Yeah.
To know that there are some other people who think, okay, you know, let's cut the crap, you know, let's just try and work things out in the best possible way.
Yeah. And I think another thing that's interesting now that I'll say for me is kind of like, it's interesting guys our age, we do actually have something to bring in the culture that's not in the culture. A lot of times you have older people coming into culture and they're just a continuation. It's just a continuation of what
used to be.
But I think guys, you know, of our age really have something to contribute that kind of got extracted from the culture for a while.
Yeah.
So I think I feel good that I'm able to contribute something at this point. I mean, it's a thing of jazz music. This is, again, going back to the whole thing of the jazz label. It's a thing of you have great jazz musicians who are still making great music at 60, 70 even.
Yeah.
So another reason why I don't mind the jazz label is because
it still has quality there.
Well, it still has that idea of you're going to still keep doing something new and unique. You know, I mean, I'm not going to mention any names, but we talked about the idea of mummification of music.
Yeah.
But I think there's still a conscious kind of stream to this mummification of jazz idea.
Jungle.